Hi guys, welcome back to ChargerLAB. On November the 5th of this year, DJI officially launched the Mavic 3 of James. It also comes with a 65W GaN charger, which is compact with increased charging speed. The product name is printed on the back and the manufacturer information is below. Open the box. Except for the charger, there is a manual inside. Remove the plastic film and the charger is black with matte surface, and the cable is fixed in the charger. There is an additional USB-A used to charge the remote controller. The AC pins are foldable and easy to carry. Let's take a look at the specs. Model is PD-65CN. It supports input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60 Hz, 2 amp, and output of 5 volts, 5 amp, 9 volts, 5 amp, 12 volts, 5 amp, 15 volts, 4.3 amp, 20 volts, 3.25 amp. It also supports the PPS of 5 to 20 volts, 3.25 amp, and the USB-A output is only 10 watts. The maximum power is 65 watts. The PDL of USB-C is different from the ordinary 65W fast charger, which is 5 amp instead of 3 amp. Only this way can it satisfy the charging requirements of the DJI Mavic 3. It's manufactured by BYD Electronics. The USB-A is black, but the USB-C is orange. The cable length is about 1 meter, and the 5 amp means it can support 5 amp current. Compared with Apple's 61W charger, the size is almost half of it. Though it supports 5A, the ChargerLAB Power ZKM001C didn't detect the eMarker chip because the cable is fixed in the charger, so it didn't need the eMarker chip. The size of the charger is 70/38/31mm, the power density is about 0.74W³/cm. The weight is about 150 grams. Let's use the ChargerLAB Power ZKT002 to test the protocol. USB-C can support Samsung 5V 2A, DCP, QC4, PD3, and PPS charging protocols. The USB-A only supports Samsung 5V 2A and DCP. And the PDO information is the same as what's printed on the shell. Then let's try to charge some devices to see its compatibility. Next, let's take apart the first DJI GaN charger. After removing the pins, we can see it is connected to the PCB module by metal contacts. Take out the internal module. We can see a layer of heatsink is wrapped outside for heat dissipation. The black insulating plate is between the heatsink and components. There is also a heatsink on the PCB's back. Remove all heat sinks, and there are lots of silicon adhesives between components. ChargerLAB found that it adopts the high-frequency QR topology to achieve wide voltage output. The protocol chip can control USB-C output, and the USB-A adopts step-down circuit to output. The specs of time delay fuse is 3.15A, 250 volts. Common mode choke is used to suppress EMI interference. The NTC thermistor is used to suppress the current when plugged in. This is safety X2 capacitors. There are two bridge rectifiers on the input small PCB to evenly dissipate heat. Those three electrolytic capacitors on the primary circuit come from AiShi, 400 volts 56 microfarad, 400 volts 33 microfarad, and 400 volts 22 microfarad, respectively. The differential mode inductor is wrapped with a heat shrinkable tube. The power supply capacitor of master control chip is also from AiShi, 100 volts 10 microfarad. And the master control chip adopts on semiconductor NCP1342, which is a highly integrated quasi-resistant flyback controller with active X2 capacitor discharge feature and has complete protection functions. This is the transformer. The blue Y capacitor is used for anti-interference. The SMD Y capacitor comes from TRX, which is very common in GaN chargers. The Everlight EL1018 optocoupler is used to regulate the output voltage. The Synchronous rectifier adopts Joulwatt's JW7726B, which has low quiescent current. It supports different working modes and high side and low side rectification. The Synchronous rectifier MOSFET is marked with B129N10. The specs of two solid capacitors are 25 volts, 560 microfarad. There are two VBUS switch MOSFETs from Vanguard VS3610AE. A protocol chip is in the middle of this small PCB, which comes from Richtek technology. No components on the back. This is the secondary step-down circuit of USB-A, located on another small PCB. The step-down chip comes from Chengxinwei CX8855, which is a DC-DC converter with 32V voltage and can realize constant voltage and constant current. It can support 3.4A continuous output current, adjustable output voltage, and has high-performance load response and input voltage response capabilities. Here is the operational amplifier used to detect the output current of the USB-A and automatically allocates power. The step-down inductor is wrapped by a heat shrinkable tube. The small inductor is used for filtering. The specs of solid capacitor of USB-A is 6.3 volts, 180 microfarad. Well, that's the teardown of DJI's first GaN charger, which may become the beginning of GaN technology in the drone industry. It has two output ports, USB-C and USB-A, and can simultaneously charge intelligent flight batteries and a remote controller. It supports PPS and PD protocols and can charge your phone, laptop, and other devices. This charger adopts high-frequency QR topology, and most components come from well-known brands such as On Semiconductor, Joulwatt, Vanguard, Richtek technology. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!